Good morning, students. We are again here to discuss about the different input devices, which was already discussed a little bit in our last session. In the last session, we have all discussed about the mouse, keyboard, different types of mouse, different types of keyboard, and many different types of hardware also a little bit. Today, what we are going to discuss is all about the different hardware materials, like the devices which are used to give some values. We all know that whenever we are giving any value to the computer, that particular device becomes an input device. So whenever we are working with input device, we are always worried how to put the data into the computer. So there are many different types of hardware which I have already discussed in the last session, where we have seen that there are a lot of devices available which among them are important. Some of them are important, some of them are little bit of, you know, not so much, but sometimes it is used for a particular purpose. Now today we are going to discuss about the joystick. I know most of you are familiar with joysticks because lot of few people are very, very interested in playing games. Nowadays we have seen that many games are already there in the in our mobiles. There we can easily understand and see and play the games very, very nicely by simply pressing on that particular touchscreen tab. But the problem is, by playing games in our mobile phones is sometimes hampering our eyes. Sometimes it is not good for us, because a long period of time playing mobile games are definitely harmful for us. Basically, it is very, very harmful for our eyes, our neck, our mind, our brain. So, long time playing is not at all good in mobile phones. So, there is some other way of playing games, that is with the help of some joystick. You know, this joystick is a very, very interesting device, input device definitely. This joystick is used to, you know, connect this with our computer. We basically connect this joystick to the computer. After that, what we see, we are basically play games with this joystick. Joysticks are sometimes good because there are many places where joysticks are used for, you know, practicing some kind of task which is very, very risky when you are practicing really. Like, if you don't know how to fly a helicopter, then you are not allowed to sit in a helicopter's pilot seat and ride the helicopter. But you can try that with the help of computer simulators or emulators, using those type of simulators with the help of joystick. You can try flying a helicopter virtually in the world of computer, like games. So their joysticks are very, very useful in those kind of areas. So we have seen, many people are saying that joysticks are mainly used for playing games, but sometimes it is not the right word. It is definitely mostly used for playing games, but there are some good places that the joysticks take a very vital role for, you know, practicing a risky task. We all know that I have already discussed you, like, you know, riding a helicopter is sometimes risky if you don't know how to, you know, ride that, how to use the buttons and all, how to ride the helicopter. So in such kind of risky places, your joysticks will be helping, because you will your computer will create a virtual world where, as if like you are in the helicopter, you are flying the helicopter with the help of this joystick, as if you have done any mistake, if you are falling from that height from the sky, there will no such problem arise. So this is basically the best part of joystick, which I feel, because it will always help you to practice many such kind of sessions like riding trains, riding, you know, such kind of risky things. So, you know, according to our syllabus, a joystick is an input device consisting of a stick that it attaches to a base. The stick moves and controls the movement of a pointer or some other display symbols on the screen. So, on the screen, you can see some other pointing device. Either it may be a mouse pointer. Mouse pointer is definitely used for mouse, so you will get a mouse pointer when you are moving a mouse only. For a joystick, if you are playing games, you will see the movement of the game that you are playing. For that only, the controlling part where you are actually controlling the game, that part is going to move according to your movement of the joystick. So joysticks are basically used for moving your parts of the games. The joysticks are commonly used for playing video games. So you can see there are some few different types of joysticks which are available. So you see, these joysticks are sometimes there are basically different 100 types of joysticks available. You can see a joystick of this left one side is common. You can see this kind of joysticks in many places, but the right hand side joysticks also not so common. It is used in most of the game parlors, where there are a lot of places where small children, kids like you, people go over there and play games by paying money. And there you will get such kind of joysticks, like the joysticks that I am pointing right now. So, joysticks are commonly used for playing video games, definitely. It is used for playing video games. Now, after that, we are coming to the next part, that is the light pin. Light pen is a such kind of device by which you can directly draw something or write something on the computer screen as if you are writing it in a copy. So the pen is capable of, you know, sensing where you are touching on the screen, and automatically you will appear that on the screen something like you are marking. So this is a very, very useful device whenever some people are, suppose, the best example is the commentator. The commentators are commenting on the play, what the play is going on, and suppose the commentator is saying that this particular area, the players are playing well. So how to mark those areas on the screen? It's very easy. Using a light pen, they only mark, and they say, like, this particular area, like I'm seeing, showing it in the screen, this particular area, suppose, I want to mark. So using this particular area, I am showing through the mouse only, but this particular area can be shown by using light pen. A light pen can only mark this area easily, and it can easily show, and everybody can see from the outside, like I want to point out this area. So this kind of, you know, help you are going to get from light pen. Also, you can draw. If you are a good drawing artist, you can draw with the help of that light pen onto the screen, which is sometimes not possible for a mouse to move. So this is a very nice way of, you know, drawing something. So a light pen is also an input device, and is shaped like a pen. It allows the user to draw or point objects on the screen. So a light pen is also an important device and is shaped like a, you know, pen. It allows the user to draw or point objects on the screen. So as you can see from the picture, if this is a laptop screen, then you can directly write something on that laptop screen. According to this picture, this is a very older version light pen screen, where in those times people used to give these kind of screens. It is important because these kind of screens are only meant for these light pens. The tip of the light pen has a light sensitive detector. Okay, yeah, there is a very small lights in the vibrator at the tip of the pen, which actually senses the senses, and your computer starts making the, you know, different pictures on the screen. Then the light pen touches the screen, the detector identifies the location of the pen on the screen. So after that, you can see the detectors can easily identify the which portion of the which portion or which part you want to, you know, point. So after that, we are coming to the next part, that is the graphic tablet. So you can see these light panes are you know, walking that way. Now we are coming to the graphic tablet. This graphic tablet is almost same like light pen, but there is a small difference between graphic tablet and light pen. In that light pen, you can draw something on the screen, but using this graphic tablet, you can only use a diary like structure where you can write something on this particular screen. You are not allowed to use your pen on the monitor or on the screen only. So this is a place where you can use it. Basically, graphic tablets are being used by the you know, art persons, those who are capable of drawing pictures, drawing images. Those people actually use this graphic tablet. So a graphic tablet is used to draw images and pictures. Basically, it is used to draw images and pictures on the computer screen. It consists of a flat surface on which the user can draw using a pen-like drawing device called stylus. Graphic tablets are of great use to artists who like to draw directly on the computer. So graphic tablets are basically a very nice, you know, computer input device by which you can easily draw something. Basically, it is best used for freehand sketch, like you are drawing in a chart paper or a page. Like that only in the graphic tablet you can draw, and whatever you are drawing, that same thing will be coming into the computer screen. So this is a nice thing, you know, it's a nice part where by which you can easily, you know, draw something or give a different shape also. Now we are coming to scanner. Scanner is something nowadays it's little bit common to you people, because we all know that scanners are basically a hardware device. Definitely, it's a hardware device by which you can, you know, put a hard copy into a softer copy. And I have already discussed you the harder copy and softer copy in my first class. So I think from there you can have that idea that the hard copy is something that we can touch and feel, the pages, the copies, the things that we can touch only, those are all hard copy. If you take a printout from the printer, that printout becomes a hard copy. Now if that same thing is there in the computer, a Word document and anything that you see in the computer is a soft copy. So scanner is used to convert any hard copy into a soft copy. So you can see from the picture here that this device is called a scanner. Inside this picture, you have to put the object, you put the page or something like that, and your scanner will copy this page, and after that, the same copy is going to, you know, fix inside the computer. So easily your computer will, you know, read this particular file from the scanner, and you can easily see that whatever you have given inside the scanner is same coming into your computer like a photo. So it's similarly, it's similar like we are taking a photo from our mobile phones of a particular thing. So if I take a photo, then the same thing will be coming into our mobile phones. So the same thing that you have taken the photo is a hard copy, and whatever you're getting inside your computer or mobile is a soft copy. So in this way your scanner helps. Now see, a scanner is a device that is used for converting printed documents or photos into electronic format. So you can easily set the printed documents or photos in an electronic format. It captures pictures and text from the paper and makes their digital copy. So whatever you are making, whatever you are scanning, that will convert into a digital form or digital copy. The digital copy can be edited, sent as attachments through emails or saved. So you can save it you can send it as an attachment to the mail, or you can also make the modification, you can make the change. So that is called editing. Editing our data means you are making the change of the data. So this can be done. There are various types of scanners, such as flatbed scanner, handheld scanner, these two basically types of scanners are mostly available nowadays, handheld scanner and flatbed scanner. And you will come to know about these handheld scanner and flatbed scanner after some few classes. In class 7 or 8, you will come to know the most commonly used is the flatbed scanner. So this is the flatbed scanner that you are seeing, and handheld scanner is something by which you can scan an object directly. So easily you can see that a flatbed scanner is basically the scanner that we are officially seeing here and there, and the handheld scanners are the scanners like if you are going inside in any shopping malls or in any places somewhere, we see that there are persons standing with a object in their hand, and they're scanning by touching that object in your body, that whether you have carried anything inside, any metal or any thing like that. So it's called metal detector. So those are all handheld scanner type. It scans the object with your hand only. It will take your hand to scan the object. So this is basically the example of a handheld scanner. So we are all done with this particular thing. We will be continuing magnetic ink character reader, MICR, in the next class. Because in the next class, what we will see is we need to define this MICR properly. Because once you are ready with, you know, graphic tablet, type pen, joystick and scanner, then it will be easier for you to work. Okay? So, today after this, you read this properly, these four elements, input devices, and then answer the question that I am going to send you after few days. Okay? So, I hope I made everything clear to you, and always, you know, comment on the on a proper place. You know everything where to comment. So you comment over there, and I'll be replying over there. If you are having any question by watching this video, a part that you don't understand, then you please comment over there and wait for my reply. Thanking you, and have a nice day.